Hello, I'm back. Today I'm showing you how to update Valeton GP-200 to the brand new firmware version 1.7.4. Step by step. So this update is a huge leap. It adds a support for NAMM files, which are a huge thing, which are AI-based amp models, and it even lets you capture your own amps or pedals. So stick around, because at the end, I'll show you how to import NAMM files. How to update the GP-200 to 1.7.4? Let's just start with this firmware update. Here is what you need to do. You go to the official Valeton GP-200 website. I'll put the link in the description. So go support, download, firmware. You choose the one it fits you. I'm going to choose GP-200 version 1.7.4. That's the one we are downloading. And then go to support, download software, and then you choose the one it fits you. GP200 is mine for Mac, and the right one for this firmware is this last one, 1.7.0. Download. So you're gonna open the zip file of the firmware, your Valeton GP200 via USB. You're going to open your software, the toolbox. You're going to firmware update. You're going to the folder. So I have mine here. Bin is the extension bin. Open and update now. Caution: to prevent data loss during firmware update, please backup your user patches first. I don't have none, so for me it's fine. Backup yours if you have it. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes. Please make sure all presets are backed up. I don't care. And as you can see here, it's updating. What are NAMM files? What all this hype around NAMM files? Very quick explanation so you understand better. The NAMM stands for Neural Amp Modeler. So it's an open source platform that uses AI to clone real guitar amps and pedals. It doesn't just model the tone amp like traditional amp sims, it captured the feel, the dynamic and the behavior of the gear, almost like digital photography of your favorite amp. With this firmware 1.7.4, the GP200 can now load these NAMM files, giving you just access to the real amp sounds, modeled from boutique heads, vintage combos, all of the high gain monsters, you just name it. Basically, just like getting access to a Kemper or a Quad Cortex level amp modeling, but on a budget. This is just $300. I'll make a more in-depth tutorial about this topic on a separate video if you wish so. Write on the comments if you are interested. Alright! Coming over again. Loading. Here we have the update, but now we have to update the software. This one. Open the zip file, install the setup. Would you like to access files? Yes. Continue, continue. I agree. And done. The software now, GP200. Here they explain everything again. You already know this probably. The click to load IR, you can load IRs, of course, drum parameters, parameters, and etc. You want to skip this one? And how to import a NAMM file? That's a good question. All right, so let me show you how to actually get these NAMM tones into your GP200. You just find a NAMM file, you can get free ones online or even create your own with the capture tool. Files usually have a .NAMM extension. You can find some awesome NAMM files on the website tone3000.com. I will leave a link below on the description, and that's it. If you go to the amp, you can go down and you can see there's snap tone 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. You have 5 slots that you can use. We can go and download NAMM files from here. You have the tone, this is just an example, but you have the tone3000.com. I'm gonna leave the link in the description. You have a bunch of free NAMM files. I just picked the one that I saw. I think it was a Marshall but you can go and, for example, this one, and they explain here, they can, you can hear the sound as well. This is just an example. You can pick the guitar, Celestine guitar, Creamy guitar, a bunch of examples. Download all. You download it and you just extract the zip file, and there is the NAMM file right here. You come back to the GP200 software, you go to your slot, right click, import NAMM file. I have here the Marshall Jubilo open. We have the step tone 1, but you can choose whatever you like. We have 5 slots, of course, and you just do load. Yes, success. You just have to choose a cab, the one you like. You have, you can tweak it all the way you want. I'm gonna leave it like this to try it out. I'm gonna take it out noise reduction, the volume, the EQ, the delay, the reverb, and I'm just gonna leave the cab. The cab, I'm gonna leave this one and see how it sounds. Because I have a Fender, I'm gonna choose the Fender Deluxe Reverb 2 on this Tone 3000. I just heard a little bit of this. And I'm going to download it all. Open the zip file, going to the software on my slot 2, right click, import NAMM file, Fender Deluxe Overdrive, and I'm gonna choose Deluxe Reverb. So I have now these ones, the Marshall and the Fender Deluxe. That's an endless world of possibilities now with this little machine. Now for the firm part, let's just see how it sounds. Not gonna say anything more, because you can hear for yourself, you can experiment for yourself, but this update is seriously puts the GP200 into a whole new league. NAMM support, amp capture, I think that's crazy value. So if you want a full tutorial on how to capture your own amp with an amp, drop a comment below and I'll make it happen. Like, subscribe and share with other GP200 users. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.